together, is that right?
Yeah, we're just chatting.
Yeah.
So I was supposed to say how BGG is going. No, sorry. I'm really tired.
Yeah,
so how's Essen going?
All are.
Tired.
Yeah.
It's a great show. Like I've been, this is my 11th Essen.
Wow.
And I love the show. I've been here more, I think I've been here almost as often as Gen Con.
Okay, I've never been to Gen Con.
Pardon?
I haven't been to Gen Con
yet. Oh, it's awesome.
Yeah.
It's awesome. Let's plug Gen Con here at
Yeah, that would be great. Have like a mini Gen Con right in the center of
right.
Mesa. That would be awesome.
That would be awesome.
I could get with that.
I love the show. It's really busy. A little bit less busy this year than it was previous years.
Well, there's been a train strike this weekend.
Right.
So I think that affected both yesterday and today.
Yeah. They should have played more Ticket to Ride.
Yeah. They should have, right?
But yeah, it was fun. So I did, I was here to do signings for, I had a bunch of games coming out, which I wasn't quite expecting. Like XCOM came out and Warhammer LCG
mm-hmm.
and Arcadia Quest came out at the same time.
Yeah.
And I just heard they announced Dungeons & Dragons Dice Masters.
Yeah.
Which I was pretty pumped about. But then they were like, no pictures.
Yeah.
So there you go.
There you go.
That was fun.
Yeah.
It was a lot of fun. But I didn't really get a chance to see any new games. So was there anything cool?
I've seen so many things now. They're all kind of mushing into each other.
Yeah.
I was telling Beth, one of my favorite demos was The Alchemist, because there's all those bits that just, and all these pieces. It's CGE's game.
Yeah, I saw it at the gathering in April.
Yeah.
And it looked, as soon as I saw the iPhone, I'm like, all right, I'm interested.
Yeah, exactly.
Because iPhones and games are good.
Yeah. I like the technology aspect. One of the things that I also liked about it is that they thought about the fact that not necessarily everyone wants to use a smartphone mm-hmm. when they're playing a game. So they do have an element where you can actually play the game without having to have...
With a moderator, right?
Yeah, so you have an extra player for the game, which seems interesting. We have a question from the chat.
A question from the chat. Hello, chat.
Is XCOM playable as a solo game?
Yes, it is. Absolutely.
Yes. Great. Good to know. That was it. Yeah, we need more questions. Keep asking, guys.
Keep asking. it's actually one of my design goals for XCOM was to make it like among the best solo playable games out there.
Yeah.
That was one of the benefits of doing it with an app. So that it was just easy to set up, easy to tear down, low on administration, but high on stress.
Yeah.
There's not enough stress in our lives.
I like having those possibilities of kind of choosing how you want to play it, because sometimes you just want to sit down and have fun with a game, and you don't always have someone to do it with.
It's true. Look at me. I have no friends.
Oh, I don't believe that.
I have to play only solo games. It's cool. It scales well, too. I mean, that was the app thing was, besides having the tutorial and making the game a little lighter, the fact that it scales, it handles all of the scaling issues, I really like. So like 2-player, 3-player, 4-player, they're different games, but they're as even as you can get in terms of difficulty.
Yeah.
Which is to say impossible on all levels.
Yeah. I like that aspect. Any more questions? No?
No more questions. What am I doing in about a month? I'm going to this amazing new convention. So there's a new convention in town. It's in Dallas-Fort Worth area. It's a DFW airport. It's called Board Game Geek Con. I'll be guesting there.
Fantastic.
And it's awesome. Fourth one, I think.
I've been to one, and it was fantastic.
It's awesome. It's one of my favorite shows, actually.
Yeah,
I'm not just because I'm here, but...
No. But it's a great way. People are just so open and welcoming, and you get to meet lots of fantastic people, and it's just that open, free gaming, and... Yeah.
Yes. I've actually pulled a bunch of games from the library just to play, because you guys have some pretty obscure stuff that I don't have.
Yeah.
And maybe I just kind of walk away with some of them.
I'm not sure if Aldi would agree with that.
No, but I don't get to play a lot of games at conventions. Unfortunately, I didn't get to play any games at Essen.
None at all.
No, I mean, this is a business show for me.
Yeah.
But it's a great, fun business show, but it's a business show.
Yeah.
I mean, hence the,
thing.
But
at
BGG, I'm going in shorts and sandals, and you know what? I may not wear pants. Like, that's how laid back it is.
That sounds awesome.
Aldi's like, no, please wear pants.
And shorts. That's not too bad. Is XCOM coming out before Christmas? As far as he knows and as far as he hopes, right?
Right. Unfortunately, I can't speak for FFG. No. I am just designer guy. Yeah. But, I mean, clearly they want it to come out before Christmas. But one of the things that I love about FFG is that they're a little bit Blizzard-like. They just, when a game's done, it's done.
Yeah.
And if it's not 100%, then they're not going to release it.
Yeah.
So, but I've seen the app, I've seen the proofs, I've seen all that stuff is away.
And
we're now just praying to the shipping gods and the tsunami.
Hope it gets there in time. Because it would be nice to have it before Christmas. I'm sure that's the kind of thing that a lot of people would want in their stockings.
I agree. Aliens in my stockings.
Indeed.
I got your micro game.
The game.
What game?
If you could ever go back and
redesign a game,
what game would it be?
That's an interesting question. So I can't give you the actual answer because the actual answer is one that I'm doing a redesign for
Ooh,
now. So and
exciting.
I can't talk about it. So a different game. I would actually go back and redesign the Dragon Ball Z board game,
okay.
Which I'm pretty sure nobody knew I even did, but. We did that way, way, way back when, and it was on a kind of a rush schedule, but like I worked on it with Daryl Hardy, and mm-hmm. we hit on what was really cool about it a little bit too late in the development process, and I would have loved to go back and just refine
just develop
it a little bit
that
more.
Idea.
Because like Dragon Ball Z is it's a license that doesn't necessarily appeal to everybody, but there's like. I truly believe that at our heart, we've got a 13-year-old in all of
us,
right?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm basically 13.
And Dragon Ball Z is that larger-than-life kind of a...
It totally is. And
Right? Just
to play a big, impossible, brawling board game where you blow up universes as the side effect of your actions, that's pretty compelling to me. I would love to make that game again.
That's cool.
Okay, the new answer.
The answer is like, no comment. Says, can we hope to see another Chaos in the Old World expansion?
Can we ever hope to see a new Chaos in the Old World expansion?
Yeah, I'm sorry guys, Aldi was right. No comment.
No comment.
I like Chaos in the Old World very much. There are a number of people who say that the game is good as it is without expansion, and there's a part of me that agrees with that. But if the timing is right, if the ideas are right,
the cards fall into place the way.
Right. There's no rush. We are not compelled to do more content for it.
Yeah,
so
what's
we're
there
only going to do
good,
it if it's
so,
right.
Yeah.
Right. If it makes the base game better.
Yeah.
And it turns out that's actually kind of challenging.
No. Oh, yeah. I can imagine. So you're heading back tomorrow?
I'm heading back. I don't know.
You don't know. Oh, that means you must be exhausted.
Oh yeah. I'm going to France for a little while to jam with some of my designer friends.
Great.
Make some games because apparently that's what we do
and
for a living.
Actually, get
between
to
between trips to famous places like Essen and BGGCon.
Yeah, and get away from a little bit of meetings and before you get to go and play games all the time.
Right. Well, there are going to be meetings about making games. Maybe making games
so
about
just going from
meetings
yeah.
So very meta.
Very, very meta.
I thought you said very metal. I was like, yeah. Yeah, so I'm out of here. We're going to go play some games, then go home and sleep for at least 5 hours.
Sounds like a good plan. At least you don't have to change time zones. At least not more than an hour if you're heading to France. Right?
Oh yeah, to France, no problem.
Yeah.
And then 5 hours to get home.
Yeah. That's not so bad.
Nope.
Oh.
That's my cue.
Yeah.
Ciao.
Yeah.
Thank you, Kevin.
It was lovely meeting you.
It's good to meet you, too. Good to meet you, Aldi.